One question that I get with Illustrator a lot is, what is the difference between the selection tool and the direct selection tool? Well, first off is the appearance. The selection tool is black and the direct selection tool is white. And that's all the difference there is. Just kidding. So the selection tool, the black arrow, essentially will manipulate an entire object. It is meant to grab one object and move that object, transform that object, etc. The direct selection tool is when you want to manipulate different parts of a specific object. So let's start with the selection tool. When I click off this object and click on it again, notice that all of the different handles are selected, and I can now grab one of the handles and transform it. I can go along the outside and rotate it, and anywhere I click, it's always going to allow me to move that object around. Even if I click off and click back on, I can move it around. Now, the direct selection tool is a little bit different. If I grab the direct selection tool, well, first let's go ahead and make this a little bit bigger. If I grab the direct selection tool, with this object selected, I can move the entire thing. Well, this kind of behaves exactly like what we just saw with the selection tool. So this is where people get a little confused, like what's the difference between the two? Well, again, the direct selection tool is going to allow you to manipulate different parts of this object. The reason why I can move the whole thing right now is because all four corner anchor points are selected. Notice that they are all filled in with this hot pink color. And by the way, it's getting its hot pink from this layer color right here. So if you needed that to change, you could double click the layer and change it here. But in order to manipulate a part of this object, let's say this top right corner over here, I can click on it once. And notice that all of the different anchor points are now hollow, except for that one particular anchor point that's full of color. So if I click and drag this anchor point, it's going to allow me to manipulate that object any way I see fit. So I can stretch it out, I can pull it up, I can do whatever I want with this part of the object. In addition, if I hold the shift key and click on another anchor point, or maybe three anchor points, it's going to allow me to move those two selected anchor points or three selected anchor points, whatever you may have, around as needed. So this really allows you to create some unique objects from basic shapes. Another cool thing about the direct selection tool is that once you go ahead and start adding anchor points, so I'll go to the pen tool to the add anchor point tool, I can go ahead and pull these anchor points in with the direct selection tool, and again, be able to create a unique object. So if I pull that in, that one, this is starting to look like an Xbox, in a weird way, an Xbox logo. But this is where the direct selection point, or the direct selection tool excels, is being able to manipulate the different anchor points or parts of objects so that you don't necessarily have to draw things from scratch, but you can kind of start with a basic shape and go from there. So for instance, let's say I wanted to grab this rectangle tool and kind of draw one out on the stage, and let's say I wanted to create a baseball diamond. Well, this is where I can grab my direct selection tool, and notice that there's not an anchor point here that I can pull down. So again, I'll grab the add anchor point and I'll line that up. And now I can switch back to the direct selection tool. And by the way, notice the keyboard shortcut for this is A and the selection tool is V. So get used to using those so you can switch between them. But for this video, I just want to move to them so you can see what I'm doing. But now I can click on that anchor point and then drag it down, and I can create a baseball diamond without having to use the pen tool essentially to actually draw this out.